My name is George Edmondson with MotionVFX.com, and today I'm going to show you how to use the brand new M-Tracker 3D expansion, Social Media. Let's get started. All right, and once again, my name is George Edmondson with MotionVFX.com. Today, we're going to be looking at the brand new Social Media Icons Pack for the M-Tracker 3D expansions. Social Media Icons Pack is now available from MotionVFX.com, and it is free. So, if you have M-Tracker 3D, you will be able to take advantage of this new expansion pack. M-Tracker 3D expansions are located in your titles browser under M-Tracker 3D expansions, and as we scroll down, you will find the Social Media Icons Pack right here. Social Media Icons Pack comes with all of the current popular social media icons: Facebook, Instagram, Patreon, Snapchat, Spotify, TikTok, Twitch, Twitter, Vimeo, and YouTube. So the first thing I want to do is find the section that I want to track with M-Tracker 3D. So I'm just going to push down in my timeline, and I know right around here is where I want to begin tracking, because we're going to take advantage of all of this beautiful space here in the foreground. So I'm going to tap B for a blade cut, and we will continue to push down, and we will do another blade cut. I'm gonna tap A for my all tool. Now I have my clip highlighted. We're going to go over into our effects to M-Tracker 3D. To apply M-Tracker 3D, simply click, drop, and drag onto our clip. Now we're going to open our inspector. And if you're familiar with M-Tracker 3D, you know that you've got two buttons that both do the same thing: track our footage with our on-screen button, or click track in our inspector. Both do the same thing, one button to track your footage. All right, now that we are done tracking, we can see that our copy track button is now enabled. So let's click copy track. And now we're going to go over and find the social media icon that we want to use first. So I think the first thing that I want to do is actually push back up. And I think we're going to try to put our social media icons there on the stairs, or maybe right in front of the stairs. Let's see. So the first icon that I want to use is going to be Spotify. So I simply click and drag and place on top of my clip. And I'm going to drag the end to match the duration of the tracked clip. Let me highlight my M-Tracker 3D. And we can see no tracking data is available. Copy it from the M-Tracker 3D effect, which we've already done. And now we are going to paste the track. Done. Tracking data saved successfully. Click OK. When we hover over our target icon, it indicates blue, so let's click that, and then we can see a 3D gizmo that moves all around our scene here, and you can see that it is taking everything into effect. Now, I do want this icon to stay straight up, so I'm going to hold shift while I'm preparing to place that icon, and I think I'm going to place it right here in front of the stairs. So let's click. And we can see that obviously is way too big. So let's go over into our inspector here, and we've got all of these parameters. I'm going to use my content scale parameter, and I'm just going to scale that down quite a bit. There we go. Perfect. Now, as you can see, we have all of these other great parameters. My light intensity can come down. As you can see, when we scale that down, our light got a bit bright. So we're going to bring that down. And since we're in the shadow, we're going to bring it down pretty decent amount. All right, that looks fantastic. Now, the light is coming from this side here, so our shadow is pretty accurate. I think that I want to soften my shadow up just a bit. So I'm going to soften that up, and I'm going to bring the opacity down just a bit because it's not too terribly bright in this area. All right, so as we bring back down, you can see that that track is perfect. We've got our Spotify there just sitting right on the ground as we push past to me playing a musical instrument called a handpan. Wonderful. I really like that. That looks great. Okay, so I want to continue to place some icons because this version of George is not only on Spotify, but he's also on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. So we're going to do the same thing. Let's go ahead and pick Facebook up. We're going to bring that in to the beginning and drag our title out to match. Highlight our clip. We're going to paste track because we still have that copied. Let's click OK. And let's go to our target icon. And again, I'm going to hold shift down and I'm just going to place that over here right beside our Spotify. Again, let's go to content scale and we can scale that down. Now, there is another trick. I'm going to press Command Z to back out. If we go down to 3D model scale, we can scale that down as well. But notice when we scale it down, it is scaling from the center. So keep that in mind. I'm going to go back Command Z and I'm going to content scale, and that will scale from the anchor point. There we go. Great. And we need to change that intensity on that light again. Almost completely down. Let's push up a bit so we can see where exactly we are in 3D space. Yeah, that's pretty close. Now, you are going to notice that we do have a shadow there on our Spotify. That's pretty easy to fix. That just means we want to bring our Spotify title up above our Facebook title. We will do that in just a second. Let's continue to push down and mess with our parameters. Our opacity on our shadow can come down a bit, and we can soften that up just a bit since we are there underneath all of these trees. I think that looks really good, and honestly, I think that we are a little bit back in Z space, if you can look there. So I think that we want to move forward just a bit. So I'm going to continue to hold shift and let's just bring that forward just a bit more in Z space. And I think we've matched those up there. Perfect. Yeah, that looks fantastic. Okay, let's do the same thing. We're going to go to Instagram, click and drag, match our duration. We're going to paste our tracked information. Click OK. Let's scale that down. Let's go ahead and place our point. So we're holding shift again. I'm gonna come over just a bit more. Continue to scale that down. Now I am really close. I do see I've got a little bit of space between Facebook and Instagram that is closer than Facebook and Spotify. So on my content position parameters, I'm just going to go on my X position and I'm just going to push that over just a little bit. There we go. Wonderful. I'm going to address those shadows now. So we know that Spotify is first, so it needs to go up, and then Facebook, and then Instagram. And now our shadows all should be behind each of our icons. So I really like this. I think I want to add a bit of text now, and I'm going to do that prior to our icons popping up. So what I would like to do is go into MTracker 3D, and let's scroll up to our title 3D, and I'm just going to use title 3D 1 here. So I'm going to pick it up, drag it in on top, and match our duration. We still have that information copied, so now we're just going to paste track. for our text. Let's click OK. We will use our target icon and holding shift down, we will click here on the ground. I'm going to scale that content down quite a bit. And let's change this to... So now we are representing to our audience motion VFX, and we can be found on each of these platforms. Now what I'd like to do, I'm going to duplicate this text by holding Option. I'm going to click and drag up, and we have now duplicated our text. All of our tracked information is still copied, so I'm going to click my target icon, and I want to place another bit of text, maybe over here along this side of the road. So let's click it. You can see motion VFX, and now I'm just going to simply say, follow us. I like that a lot. I'm going to go into my content rotation, and I'm just going to rotate this text a bit on Y, just to give it a little bit of depth, a little bit of character there. So let's see how this is looking. Okay, and that is it from me today. Thank you for checking out our brand new Social Media Icons Pack Expansion Kit for MTracker 3D, now available from motionvfx.com. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.